G'day and welcome back to Build Some and the 14th presentation on the series on the timber framing code or AS1684. This one we're going to look at working out the size of the ridge for our particular building. So there is one rule for the ridge, which is rule 7.2.12, and it refers to table 7.6, which if you remember from the collar tie video, it talks about miscellaneous items. So rule 7.2.12, ridge says that ridge boards shall be provided to locate and stabilise rafter ends. Opposing pairs of rafters shall not be staggered by more than their own thickness on either side of the ridge junction. Size of the ridge board shall be determined from table 7.6. Junctions of ridge boards, or hip or valley rafters shall be strutted where the hip or valley rafter exceeds 5 metres in span, or where underpurlins are supported off hip or valley rafters. Where a ridge board is required to be strutted along its length, there is insignificant or insufficient strutting supports, the ridge board shall be designed as a ridge beam for a non-coupled roof, or alternative provisions made for the full support of roof loads. Note, an example of an alternative would be the provision of a tie bolt truss. So rule 7.3.17 is the other members or components. So says that the requirements for miscellaneous roof framing members which are not given in the span tables of the supplements are specified in table 7.6. Junctions of ridge board and hip and valley rafters shall be strutted where the valley exceeds 5 metres, we just read through that, and roof strut length shall be measured from the underside of the underpurlin ridge board hip rafter to the top of the strutting beam or wall. Okay, so here's table 7.6. And you can see it's got a few different members down the side, ridge boards, valley rafters, hip rafters, valley boards, struts, collar ties, etc. So obviously for this video we want to look at ridge boards, and in this case we've got an unstrutted ridge in a coupled roof, so we have to use these. So it says that the depth of the ridge is not less than the length of the rafter plumb cut and 19mm thick. Okay, so we need to know what our rafter plumb cut is. So if we look at our rafter, we worked out in a previous video that our rafter is going to be 140mm deep, or wide if you like. So we actually need to work out what the length of this plumb cut is. Okay, so the easiest way to do that is to divide 140 by cos and the roof pitch. And the roof pitch in this case is 30 degrees, so 140 divided by cos roof pitch gave us 161mm. Okay, so we have to be at least 161mm or larger for our width, or the depth of our ridge. So our standard size is sort of 170, so I'm going to say we're going to use 170 by 19 for our ridge material. So there we go, we've worked out the size of our ridge material for this particular roof, 170 by 19.